I've got to admit, the bigger skeleton the director was talking about was indeed a huge one. I was dumbstruck when I was faced with the legendary Tyrannosaurus. Even in my dreams, I would never fathom that our museum was in possession of such a treasure. A completed skeleton of Tyrannosaurus looked majestic, and I had the honor to contribute to it. Yet another beautiful moment that has been etched in my memory forever. I graduated from college at the age of 24. I was pretty amped up. My marks were great, so I didn't anticipate any problems finding a job, but that was about to change soon. For the first 6 months after graduation, my focus was to find a job in the field of paleontology, or at least something that relates to it. I submitted my resume for every paleontologist job I could find, but the jobs were either already taken or I lacked the experience. After 6 months, I started looking for any job, but that also didn't come easily. I was trying hard, but to no avail. 1 year after graduation, things finally started to turn around, although it wasn't exactly how I had imagined it. My grandfather left his car workshop to me in his will. I wasn't particularly talented when it came to the automotive world, but I knew a thing or two, and at that time, the thought of becoming a car mechanic was at least something. He had a lot of weird and crazy ideas. There was one time Grandpa bought an old Russian truck that was clearly beyond fixing, but that didn't scare him. He always used to tell us he'd finally finish repairing it. Unfortunately, his body didn't catch up with his spirit, and he had to pass on his little project. I decided to clean up the workshop for him. Found the lost fossil piece that I found during the school trip. Despite it being over 15 years ago, I felt the exact same mix of excitement and joy that I'd felt on that beach years ago. The desire to search for fossils has become immediately obvious. With full force, all my problems suddenly ceased to exist, and I quickly came up with a plan. I just had to put it into action. I started implementing my plan by acquiring a set of excavation tools. This was possible thanks to a garage sale. The newspaper I found while cleaning the garage gave me an idea to call my university professor. During our conversation, it turned out that he was about to start a new phase of research in exactly the same place as before. However, a lot has changed since then. The quarry has been closed and the underground search for fossils will be conducted at a deeper level than before. Despite the limited budget he had at being in the mine, without any problem, I noticed the My first professional excavation was an experience that I'll always remember. A few hours later, he arrived at the excavation site in person and confirmed my assumptions. What I found was part of a dromaeosaur. Thanks to the publicity of the discovery, the town authorities decided to establish a new paleontological museum in the closed sports hall, for which they had been looking for a purpose for some time. The professor was appointed director of the Museum of Paleontology. Even before the facility was opened, I unexpectedly had received an interview invitation from him. Knowing me and seeing my commitment, he decided to offer me a job as a collection manager. I remember being speechless for a moment, but of course, I couldn't refuse. That is how the new stage of the adventure of my life began. I got a longed-for job and a chance to make discoveries that I've been dreaming about since I was a child.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.